everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be finding the area between two polar curves. And in this particular problem, we've been asked to find the area that lies inside the polar curve r equals 1 plus 2 cosine theta, and at the same time outside the polar curve r equals 2. And I've gone ahead and graphed both of the polar curves, first on a Cartesian plane and then on a polar coordinate system. I think if you can graph the polar curves, it'll help you figure out exactly which area you need to look for, and I think especially when you start working in a polar coordinate system, it makes things easier for you. So I went ahead first and graphed them in a Cartesian plane and then in a polar coordinate system, and you can see down here we've got two points of intersection that I've identified here, and those are going to be the things that we look for first, because those points of intersection are going to define our upper and lower limits of integration, which we're going to plug in here to our formula for alpha and beta. So to find those points of intersection, we can go ahead and set the curves equal to one another. Since they're both equal to r on the left side of the equations, we can set the right sides of the equations equal to one another. So we'll get 2 equals 1 plus 2 cosine theta. We'll subtract 1 from both sides and get 1 equals 2 cosine theta. And then we'll divide both sides by 2 and get 1 half equals cosine theta. So if you look at your unit circle from trigonometry, you need to look for the points on the unit circle where the x-coordinate along the circle is equal to 1 half, because remember that on the unit circle, cosine is equal to the x-coordinate, sine is equal to the y-coordinate. So you want to know where the x-coordinate is equal to 1 half. And that occurs at both pi over 3 and 5 pi over 3. So since those are the two angles where that is true, theta has to be equal to pi over 3 and 5 pi over 3, which means that these points of intersection are located at pi over 3 and the angle 5 pi over 3. So since the area that lies inside the first curve and outside the second curve is this part I've shaded in blue over here, that means that we're going to be integrating from 5 pi over 3 to pi over 3. And since this is the lower limit of integration, we want to change it into negative pi over 3. Remember that with a unit circle, right, I'm just going to draw this small over here. If we have a unit circle, we can go counterclockwise in this direction, an angle of 5 pi over 3, and arrive at, you know, something right about here. We can also go clockwise in the opposite direction, an angle of pi over 3, and arrive at the same location. So we can change positive 5 pi over 3, which is this part, into negative pi over 3, which is this part, and have it still be the same. But because this 5 pi over 3 is our lower limit of integration, we want to go ahead and transform it. So now we can plug our limits of integration into our area formula. And I'll go ahead and do that up here. So the area formula is going to be a equals 1 half times the integral, and the lower limit of integration again is negative pi over 3. The upper limit of integration will be positive pi over 3. And then we notice that we have our outer curve squared minus the inner curve squared. You can see from the graph over here that this orange curve is the outer curve and the green curve is inner, because the orange curve is farther away from the origin than the green curve. So the orange curve is this 1 plus 2 cosine theta. So we'll have 1 plus 2 cosine theta squared, that's the outer curve, minus the inner curve, which is just r equals 2 squared d theta. So now we just want to go ahead and simplify this integral before we integrate. And it'll take us a couple steps to do that, but we're going to go ahead and multiply this whole thing out. So when we multiply 1 plus 2 cosine theta times 1 plus 2 cosine theta, in other words, when we distribute this squared exponent here, we'll get 4 cosine squared theta plus 4 cosine theta plus 1. This obviously just becomes minus 4 here. So when we combine those two things together, that plus 1 and the minus 4, we'll end up with 4 cosine squared theta plus 4 cosine theta, and then we have a plus 1 minus 4 gives us a minus 3 d theta. So now what I want to do is go ahead and work with this first term here for cosine squared of theta. Notice that I have this other formula here, and it's a double angle formula because of this 2 theta inside the cosine. So what I'm going to do is transform this 4 cosine squared theta into 2 times 2 cosine squared theta. And notice I haven't changed anything at all, because if I multiplied the 2 by 2 cosine squared theta, I'd get 4 cosine squared theta. So I haven't changed anything, but I've now pulled out this 2 cosine squared theta, which matches the left side of my formula. And the reason I'm making this substitution is because I want to get rid of the cosine squared, because that's more difficult to deal with than just this cosine of 2 theta here. So I'm going to go ahead and substitute cosine of 2 theta plus 1 in for 2 cosine squared theta. And I'll end up with 2 times cosine of 2 theta plus 1. So when I multiply that out, I'll get 2 cosine of 2 theta plus 2. And now I can combine that with the other terms in my integral. So I'll have negative pi over 3 to upper limit pi over 3. So I'll have 2 cosine of 2 theta plus 4 cosine of theta, and then I have plus 2 minus 3, which gives me a minus 1 d theta. Okay, so now I'm at a point, I don't have my cosine squared term anymore, so that's going to make it a lot easier for me to integrate. I can go ahead now and take the integral. So I'm going to get area equals 1/2, and I'll go ahead and draw a big bracket so that I know where my integrated portion of my equation stops and starts. So 1/2 times, now we know that the integral of cosine of theta is sine of theta. So in order to take the integral of 2 cosine of 2 theta, we'll just get 2 sine of 2 theta. But then because we have 2 theta here inside the cosine function, we have to use chain rule and divide by the derivative of 2 theta. The derivative of 2 theta is just 2, which means we need to divide this whole thing by 2. And that's just an application of chain rule. So that's the integral of 2 cosine of 2 theta. Then we have plus 4 sine of theta, which is the integral of 4 cosine theta. And then the integral of 1 is just theta. And we'll be evaluating this on the range negative pi over 3 to positive pi over 3. Okay, so now we can go ahead, we can cancel out these 2's here, and we can go ahead and plug in our upper and lower limits of integration. So we'll end up with 1/2. So plugging in the upper limit of integration first, we'll get sine of 2 times pi over 3, which is just going to be sine of 2 pi over 3, plus 4 sine of pi over 3 minus pi over 3. And then we'll subtract what we get when we plug in our lower limit of integration. So we'll end up with sine of negative 2 pi over 3 plus 4 sine of negative pi over 3. And then minus a negative pi over 3 is going to be a plus pi over 3. Okay. So we've gone ahead and plugged in our limits of integration. Now we can go ahead and simplify from here to solve for our area. So we'll need to use our unit circle to evaluate some of these values. If you look at your unit circle and you go to the angle 2 pi over 3, since we're looking for sine of 2 pi over 3, you want to look at the y coordinate of the angle 2 pi over 3. And when you do that, sine of 2 pi over 3 gives you a positive square root of 3 over 2. So we'll end up with square root of 3 over 2 plus sine of pi over 3 is positive square root of 3 over 2 as well, times 4 gives you 4 times the square root of 3 over 2. And then we'll go ahead and leave minus pi over 3 alone. So minus pi over 3. And then we'll end up with minus sine of negative 2 pi over 3 is, remember, just like we did over here with the unit circle, you would start with the unit circle here and go an angle of 2 pi over 3 in this direction, and wherever you end up, which I think it's going to be 4 pi over 3, you would take the y-coordinate there. In this case, it's negative square root of 3 over 2, so we'll end up with negative square root of 3 over 2. And then, same thing, taking sine of the angle negative pi over 3, you'd go pi over 3 in this direction on your unit circle, you'd hit 5 pi over 3, and the y-coordinate there is still going to be negative square root of 3 over 2. So we'll end up with minus 4 times the square root of 3 over 2. And then we have plus pi over 3. Okay, so now if we're going to simplify this, we'll get 1 half times square root of 3 over 2 plus 4 times the square root of 3 over 2 is 5 times the square root of 3 over 2 minus pi over 3, and then we'll end up with plus the square root of 3 over 2 because we have a negative sign here and a negative sign here that cancel one another to get a positive sign. We'll also, for the same reason, end up with plus 4 times the square root of 3 over 2 and then a minus pi over 3. So now when we combine these one step further, we'll get 1 half times 5 times the square root of 3 over 2 plus square root of 3 over 2 plus 4 times the square root of 3 over 2 is going to be 10 times the square root of 3 over 2. That accounts for this term, and this term. And then we end up with minus 2 pi over 3. So minus 2 pi over 3. And now we can go ahead and distribute our 1 half fraction here. So when we do that, we'll find that area equals, I'm going to multiply out the 1 half, so we'll get 10 times the square root of 3 over 4 minus 2 pi over 6, and 2 pi over 6, perfect. And then when we combine this fraction into 1, we'll need to, let's first reduce them. So we can divide both fractions through by 2 and end up with 5 times the square root of 3 over 2 minus pi over 3. Now we want to find a common denominator, so we'll multiply this first fraction times 3 over 3 and this one by 2 over 2 to get a common denominator of 6. And when we do that, we'll end up with 15 times the square root of 3 over 6 minus 2 pi over 6, so we can put them both over 6. And our final answer ends up being 15 times the square root of 3 minus 2 pi over 6. And that is the area that is inside r equals 1 plus 2 cosine of theta, and outside r equals 2, which you see is this blue shaded region over here. So that's it. I hope this video helped you guys, and I will see you in the next one.